Thank you very much for a kind introduction. Good afternoon, everybody. Today I would like to my ability on genome sequence and relationship with my resources. So, as you know, the cost of genome sequence is quite rapid. Now, you know, this is the data from the NCBI to estimate the cost for human genome size genome. So starting from 100 million dollars to now around 10,000 dollars. So it's very natural to sequence more and more organisms. So this is supported by the quite rapid advancement of sequencer and related equipment. So as you know, the second generation is a short read and initial clusters are sequenced. But now you know we have every 2 or 3 years the production comes 5 times or 3, 4 times. Now you know we have the latest machine called Novasnek 6000 produced 6,006 terabases, even you know even short. But as a third generation sequencer compact I/O, now you know this sequence is very very productive machine. But now, this year, we will have soon the second version 2 of the sequence. Now, you know, the production becomes 8 times more. And this sequence has a very, the read length is very short, but the number of reads become much many. So the production becomes bigger. And then PacBio is recently almost more than 20 KB sequence have to be delivered obtained. So the, this is a very difficult long read sequence. And now the fourth generation, now also now sequence is very become popular. So first it's a very small sequence, but now the advancement has been made to produce a chromatin. This is, you know, originally it's produced only 10 gigabases, but now it's 15 times more sequences, you know, obtained with one part plate, it's produced 150 gigabytes. And the promethium accommodates 48 you know, sequence cells. So altogether, 8 terabases can be obtained. So this is also a very long sequence. Sometimes 1 megabase sequence can be obtained. So, and furthermore, the pre-treatment and the post-treatment is very important. For example, very low amount of samples and the single cell analysis, some various equipment has been developed and become very popular. So using this, a much more larger analysis and much finer analysis can be reached. So, however, you know, DNA sequencing becomes the essential wide range of sciences shown in this symposium. And advancement of DNA sequencers and related machines is quite very rapid. Every 2 years or 3 years, a new machine, new technology has been emerged. But you know, just know, introduce the new machine is not sufficient. You know, pre or pre-treatment or post-treatment technology is quite essential. This is something that is a know-how. So, and with, together with the advanced bioinformatics method is essential. All these, you know, conditions is very important to use the latest technology or machine. However, it is very difficult for individual laboratories to introduce these advanced machine or technology. And you know, in Japan, you know, most universities has core facilities, but it's content very poor because of the budget cut. So maintenance was very, very difficult. So, you know, centralization should be effective and should be made. So the genome science group in Japan established a platform for advanced genome analysis for basic sciences. So this is called the platform for advanced genome science. We call it PAGS, PAGS. So this, you know, activity has three activities. One is managing. And what this big activity is consisting of five sequencing centers. This is large scale DNA sequencing. Two major groups. One is NIG at Mishima, and another one is University of Tokyo at Kashima. These two centers has a big sequencing facilities. And together with these sequencing centers, advanced bioinformatics group established. This is a network of many laboratories. They, you know, developed their own bioinformatics technologies to provide this technology to the other projects. In this platform, this group accepted application from researchers get obtained KAKENHI project. KAKENHI means a grant aid for scientific research in Japan from the Ministry of Education, the Science and Technology in Japan. So most of the science researchers in Japan, universities and institutions, depend on this. So from this project, we selected project for, you know, this platform. So summary, PAGS PAGS is also supported by KAKENHI granting aid for scientific research. The PAGS consisted of three activities, one managing and including LC support and large sequencing DNA centers, two major centers, NRG and and advanced bioinformatics group. This is a consisting of 17 laboratories among Japan. The altogether, you know, 50 members, plus of course postdocs from 18 universities of our institution. And for the clarity, to keep a clarity, we established a review committee outside in Paris. Review committee selects applications for genome analysis based on the KAKENHI project. And once selected, the Paris provides the state-of-the-art technologies both in genomics and bioinformatics. This we call it PAGS support. And PAGS members developed the technology and raised experts by, you know, providing this technology to the public as a collaboration. So this is a, so in a sense a very positive spiral. And we expect this positive spiral, which lead to further advancement of human society. This is the concept of this protocol. This is at the top page of KAKENHI. full name is Granting Aid for Scientific Research. You call it's kake in Japanese, so it's long. So it is encouraged to use this kake for this grant name by the Ministry of Education and Technology. And this fund is distributed through Japan Society for the Promotion of Science. So, including me, most of the basic researchers depend on this coming key. And the demand for genome analysis is very wide. Initially, you know, the genome analysis means that do not genome assembly to get information of the genome. But once the reference genome is established, variation analysis and epigenetic analysis, of course, RNA analysis is very important, becomes important. Furthermore, data genome analysis also. And then recently, single cell analysis, single cell variation analysis or expression analysis into the level of single cell is very popular and demanded. So to cope these demands, we have you know, in through the core two centers using these machines, we the targets provide the selected campaign project. These genome analysis, variation analysis, and modification epigenome analysis, and other analysis, and metagenome analysis, and single cell related analysis provided as a collaboration. So currently, you know, we try to you know update the sequence machine as much as possible. So now we have two NovaSeq machines and PacBio. Soon we will have a CBF2, one, two. And also, Promotion is working very well. And as a 10x genomics and CBF6 also used very frequently. And using this, the application to PACs quite increased. This figure shows the application to public support. Actually, you know, this system has been established 8 years ago, and after 6 years, a renewal has been made. So now it's a second, 3 years, second term. So every year we accept the hundreds of applications from the company of awarded projects. But due to the budget limit, we can provide fund support only 40% of the application. But anyway, every year we supported more than 100 projects. And the breakdown of the technologies provided by public support is like this. Altogether, 100 to 200 samples have been made. Among these, RNS analysis and epigenetic analysis are very numbers high. But de novo analysis is also you know, 30 or 20. Among these, the many is bacteria or microorganisms analysis, but plant and animals, such a large genome analysis is also accepted. Probably more than 10 projects every year. So, and based on the public support, the papers have been published very quickly. So it may take time, but the time has been increased. Now then, the high impact paper also include. So by centralizing the genome analysis technologies, academia supported by Carnegie has get a big merit. And the application to come support by sorry, it's written in Java, but this is a Carnegie review section tape. And there's many, this is the unit of application section. One of this is the researchers in Japan apply to Kaken He on this based on this the review section. The review section review has been made and the selection has been made. It's made. And this green part the biological sciences. These are this biology and agriculture biology and the pharmacology and medical sciences like this. And this is physical science and engineering. And this is the section of humanities. This is very integrated research here, like environmental sciences. And the red color means selected by the sample, and blue means applied. So the most of the biosciences section is covered by the public sample. So this means the demand and our production is providing and to produce more outcome. So I think it's very successfully carried out and produce a very good outcome. But this activity can be used for viruses too. As shown by Dr. Bata yesterday, we have an NBR 30 resources in NBRP. But we have also a genome information upgrade program is now. So this is to improve the quality or the resources analysis is encouraged to carry on. So far, it has been carried out long time ago. For the last 5 years, for example, this year, we have two projects. One is from rice bioresources. This is genome sequencing of all the species, hundreds of all the species with a very low coverage sequencing. It's a little bit the diversity within the poison species. Another one from the Africa, a proposal from wheat. This is also the mutant population from which people are searching the desired mutant. this project is aiming at the sequencing of this mutant population to speed up the mutant search. And another one is like this. But among these, the divine sequence is only this chrysanthemum. This is a very big genome. So now we kind of whole genome sequence as a reference sequence is in progress, or almost finished. But other, you know, projects, mostly, you know, real sequencing or something like this, to analyze that diversity of the resources. So it used to be originally, you know, genome analysis to get very high quality reference sequence for reference strength. But now, you know, it's used to characterization, it used for characterization of many strengths, of many resources, even, you know, as a quality control. And through this information, maybe comparing these diverse strengths, we can get, we'll be able to get the genome information underlying such a diversity. All the, you know, the information obtained through this program are open at the NDRP information site, so we can get this information. So, at least we wish to contribute our DNS genome analysis activity to Bioresources. So, thank you very much for your attention. Please be in your time.